For the past few weeks, Donald Trump has really been enjoying himself as these Republican freaks from Washington, D.C. have shown up at his trial, spoken to the media, violated his gag order for him, and he loves it. He loves having these people that love him sitting behind him in the courtroom, right? Lauren Boebert, Matt Gaetz, Tommy Tuberville, Byron Donalds, Anna Luna, all of these people and many more have shown up in recent weeks to support Donald Trump. And then again, a lot of them go out and try to violate his gag order for them, for him, excuse me. But according to one of Donald Trump's former lawyers, Tim Parlatore, this strategy that Trump has of wanting his friends to come into the courtroom probably going to backfire on him with the jury. In an interview this past weekend with CNN, Parlatore said this. When it comes to a criminal trial, there are only 12 opinions that matter, and yours is not one of them. Of course, he's referring to Donald Trump. And so what impact is that going to have on the 12 people in the box, bringing this clown car of freaks in here? I'm concerned that by parading these figures in and out, that would have a negative impact on the jury. I know that there was an incident where a couple of members of Congress came in, yeah, not during a break, and they were somewhat disruptive, and the judge was looking angrily down. That's the kind of thing that jurors notice, Parlatore said. But whether the jury actually takes something from that or if they just kind of set it aside, juries are funny things. So he says, maybe there's a chance that the jury's just like, hey, that was weird, but whatever, let's get back to it. Or more likely, Parlatore's suggesting, the jury is going to see these Republican freaks coming in and out of the courtroom every day, realizing that for them, this is nothing more than political theater, and they're going to hold it against Donald Trump because they're not taking it seriously. He's not taking it seriously, but the jury is. Sacrificing weeks of their lives to be in that courtroom 4 out of 5 days of the week, and these people are turning it into a freak show. They're turning it into a sideshow attraction, and it's distracting them from being able to do the job that they are hired, you know, in a sense, to do. So Donald Trump wants more and more of his little freaks to come into that courtroom. His own former lawyer, Parlatore, who of course dumped him last summer, but still says he maintains a good relationship with him, is out there telling him this is bad strategy. But it also serves another purpose, as I've repeatedly said. It's not just about having Trump's friends come in and violate the gag order for him later. They're doing this. His lawyers are doing this because they want to keep Trump under control. And so far, they've been able to because they parade his friends in there. He doesn't want to look like a jackass in front of all of his buddies, so he keeps his cool. So as much as real lawyers are saying this is a dumb idea, they can't not do it now because they're right at that finish line. And if Trump screws up between now and, you know, next week during closing arguments, that is really going to have an impact on the jury no matter what. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.